evening, folks. Just go ahead and do what you're doing. My name is Tad Baker, and I have been asked by the Northern California Collective Consciousness to present my gas chamber this evening. And while I do that, I'd also like to clear up a few of the misconceptions that are going on around about this chamber. And I'd also like to say that in less than a week, we are the state of California gassing a man. This evening, what we're doing is we're going to examine this chamber. Now, we are not here, by the way, to change minds, to debate the rightness or the wrongness of this chamber. We have a chamber. We use it. It's going to be used in less than 5 days. What we want to do is examine our feelings. Take a look at what this chamber does. Now, let me first say that this is an original reproduction of the gas, the single-seat gas chamber used in California up until 1954. This is not the chamber that is currently used. It will be used on Tuesday morning. This is the single seat. I think some of you people have the floor diagram of the two-seater. Now, this chamber was passed on to me by Demetrius Toteras in 1979. Demetrius Toteras and his people built this in the late 60s from the original floor plans and materials. And he took this throughout the state of California and then on throughout the world on accumulated in about a 5-year tour. This particular chamber has been through hell. It is, as you can see, it is held together through everything. It has been on ships, airplanes, it has been to Russia, China, it has been all over the world several times. It fell into my hands with a promise that I made to Demetrius Toteras, and that was to present this as often as I can. And while this particular machine scares the hell out of me, I am living up to that promise because, as I said, in a few days, a man is going to be executed in a machine similar to this. Now, I spent time several years ago going over the tapes, the recordings, the files and the various documents from the tour. It led me into an area that I don't think any of us are familiar with, nor are we interested in really dealing with, thus the importance of bringing this thing to light. This chamber represents the state of California and the justice we are serving. This chamber is, like I said, frightening to me. And I want it to be frightening to everybody because what we are about is taking a look at what this thing does. Now, again, as I said, this is not an actual two-seater, this is the single seat. But it is right down to the bone accurate. Some interesting things about the single seat. Up until 1939, they hung people in California. In 1938, they decided, because of the last execution they did, removed the head of a man with a noose. They decided it was time to bring in another more humane form of execution. And so they spent several years developing this. This particular model is patterned after the Colorado State Gas Chamber. It was built in 1938 by Eaton Metal Products. What they did initially was to gas a 400-pound pig. They figured it would take up to 30 seconds to kill the animal. And that procedure lasted over 15 minutes. So what was originally designed to be a very humane and very quick form of death has dragged into scenes such as Leandris Riley in 1949, who was the third individual to be gassed in the two-seater. I don't know if any of you people are aware, he escaped, he's a very small man, he escaped from his bonds several times, racing around the chamber, pounding on the windows. He had to be restrained 3 different times, and finally, after 15 minutes of struggling, he succumbed. The chamber, like I said, was originally designed for humane purposes. But what it has led to are scenes such as Aaron Mitchell's execution in 1967, which a friend of my uncle's who was on the Toteris tour, Howard Brody, has related to me. He was the court artist who followed the executions from 1959 to 1967. He told me his firsthand account of the Aaron Mitchell execution, and it was the most gruesome thing I have ever heard. As some of you, I'm sure, know, he went into some type of frenzy before the execution, claiming he was Jesus Christ. He tried to slash his wrists. He literally did everything he possibly could to save himself. Such was not the case. He died as the last person in California in our chamber. While uncovering some of the research and the history behind this chamber, I was startled by how much attention, how much emotion people feel about this particular unit. Reading the account of the Davy Miranda execution from 1963 startled me. This man had, he was in, I believe it was 6 years, he went through 6 years of appeals. He said in the journals that he had only one dream for the last 3 years when he was incarcerated. He had one dream, and that was walking down from death row into the chamber. And in the court documents, his personal journal, he clearly defines the agony and the torture that he felt. He'd wake up in the middle of the night and the dream would be the same. Because see, this is something that most people don't ever get a chance to experience. Most of us die naturally or by accident. But for people like David Miranda, he knew the exact time, down to the second, that he was to die. In fact, he said in the journals, he said, "My most horrible dream was walking down and seeing every little detail." He had mapped out every single detail of what would happen, down to when the crank turned and sealed him in, the sound of the gas rushing through the pipes, his very last breath, the executioner telling him to take a deep breath quickly so that it wouldn't hurt. Now, this procedure, this is, like I said, if you'll refer to the diagrams you have, you'll see some differences between the single-seater and the two-seater. This is based on an older system where you drop the cyanide into the receptacle here. The executioner actually stands at the base of the chamber, what happens is there's some cyanide that drops into here and some distilled water. That mixture comes in here. This is released, which releases sulfuric acid. It all flows underneath the chair and comes up engulfing the victim, the deceased, in a few minutes. This chamber, since 1979, has been in Japan and Greece intermittently. It was the subject of a film done in 1969 by Jay Epping for the Edinburgh Film Festival. Since 1979 to 87, it was, like I said, in Greece and Japan. I retrieved it in 87, and I've been taking it around the country intermittently. Some people I know from the various coalitions against the death penalty asked me several months ago to bring it, if all the appeals fail, to bring it forth and to let the people experience this thing. Because like I say, this is not hanging. This is not a lethal injection. This is something, as you can see, that works almost like a Victorian time machine. It is cranks and levers out of a former age. So, a couple weeks ago, we had all agreed to take this around San Francisco and to show the various people. But as some of you may know, we experienced all sorts of hassle in the community, threats against my group, the various groups. Suffice to say that people didn't want to see it. People didn't want to be reminded of its presence. And like I've told some of the people, several weeks ago, we would be quite willing to show this openly around San Francisco without any problem. But in the last 2 weeks, with all the flack that we've gotten, I've had to bring it in here tonight for you people as a private showing, because I just can't take it out into the streets before Monday at 6 o'clock, because that is the full intention of bringing this down in front of the gates of San Quentin. Now, this evening, as you probably know, I don't have any prepared script. I'm just going from my own personal experience with this. Like I said, this is an original reproduction down to the very square inch. It is obviously not functional. We've removed several of the pieces. But we had planned, last weekend, Mike Bauman and I had planned to take this thing around and to let the whole world see it out in the streets. It didn't work out that way. Again, we received a lot of flack, so that's why I brought you folks in here tonight, to give you an opportunity to see this thing, to ask me any questions you may have, and to let this thing get out into the hands of the people, because as you can see, it's a contraption that we don't ever get a chance to witness. Now, we are going to be presenting this chamber at the Sunrise Vigil atop Mount Davidson at 7 o'clock this Sunday morning. We have people from the Archdiocese of San Francisco will be there. We have some people from the Glide Memorial. They're coming, Glide Memorial. And from what I understand, there is an envoy from Mother Teresa that has, I can only hope will show up. I can't guarantee that. Also, we are in contact with the ex-chief executioner of California. But like I say, I can't guarantee anybody showing up for this thing. What's happening is we're gassing someone very early for Tuesday morning. And it occurs to me that none of us really understand our feelings about this issue. None of us really have a grasp on it. When I brought this out around the country, when I was with Toteris years ago, the questions, the violent responses showed me that we execute and we don't even think about it. And so why I'm here this evening is for us to take a look at this, to get a feeling for it. I want to know what I feel. I want to know what it feels like to execute a man. I don't want to quickly grab my opinion, pro or con, and walk away. Because this is what we do in California. We execute in a machine similar to this. So Tuesday morning, Robert Harris will walk into a chamber a little larger than this, a few more contraptions, but for all intents and purposes, the same thing. 16 pellets of cyanide get dropped into distilled water and get blended with sulfuric acid and engulf him. And the executioner will say the same thing he has said to everyone else. Take a good deep breath and get it over with quickly. Like I said earlier, this chamber frightens me. But I need to see it. I think everybody needs to see it. I want everyone to see it. Because we do execute in this state. It's not a question of, is it right or wrong? Is this an actual gas chamber? Who are you people? That's not the point, folks. The issue tonight is gassing a man. It's been 23 years since we gassed a man. Now, this chamber is going to be singing 6 o'clock in front of the San Quentin, if all goes right. I've had threats from all over the community saying if it shows up on the highway, we're going to burn it. And yet, isn't that funny? They don't say a thing about the burning of the man in the chamber. What I'm seeing is value systems that are all paradoxical. Value systems that are all screwed up. People who don't know what their feelings are. So tonight we're going to explore it. Photograph, look at it. Please don't touch. It's an old unit. It's been through hell. I look at it, and I swear, I've been with this thing for almost 20 years, and every time I look at it, I get chills. I saw people in Moscow in the late 70s. I saw a woman rush the stage with a knife and try to cut into this thing. I've seen people freaking out. I've seen people cheering it. I've seen all facets of people acting with this thing. But again, this is what we do. ladies and gentlemen, we are looking at a garbage disposal. A garbage disposal for the flotsam and trash of our society. It actually also is the vehicle that we sacrifice to the God of justice. Much like the Aztecs or the early Greeks did. But what separates us from the Greeks, Aztecs, is that those cultures offered up the best and the brightest to be given as a true sacrifice to the gods. We as moderns use this as a garbage disposal to remove those from amongst us we don't want around.
Sunrise. Almost 7 a.m., April 1st, 1990. At the foot of the cross sits the chamber. Parallel forms of capital punishment. Ah, yes, the execution of truth and justice. Here atop Mount Davidson in San Francisco.
Because what it means is that lives are being taken. This represents taken life. Willed taken life, I guess the Germans would call that. Imagine knowing the moment when you were to die. Like Christ knew the feeling of it. He didn't have it to the moment. But Robert Harris and the people that pass through this machine have it to the moment. They have it right down to the second when they're going to die. It's a different type of thought. Just like that chamber is a different type of thought than that cross. It's a more sophisticated thought. You know, and they said it was sacrilegious to place this before this cross. Do you remember the phone call we had? You know, it struck me like, once again, the nature of the whole thing, the absurdity of the whole thing. You know, I agreed with the guy. I said, it is sacrilegious. You're right, man. The whole thought of it. The thought of all of us killing a man. So we bring it up here so we can see its sacrilegiousness. We place both of them together to remind us of that. Imagine if we had the gas chamber 2,000 years ago, we'd be hanging that around our neck, wouldn't we? We may be in 1,000 years. You know, I was reading the diary of Davy Miranda, the guy that was killed in 63, 64, I can't remember. And, you know, the 3 years before he was executed, somebody mentioned the green color. He said he had one dream. It recurred almost every night, or when he'd take a nap.
was constant with him. It was the process from the coming down the death walk into the death cell. And he said the colors stood out. It got to be almost an obsession with him, the colors, the vividry of the colors. You know, he did watercolors and such in prison. And, you know, he had never seen the chamber. He didn't know what it looked like. And apparently his watercoloring was very close to the color of the chamber. He pulled it out of his head. You know, it's interesting. Look how we laid our people out 2,000 years ago. We laid us out wide open like this for the god to come and take us, right? And what does that thing do?
It hides us. Crumples us into
it. It comes in at you.
Surrounds you. Everything.
Surrounds you and knocks you out. You know, when that guy called and said, oh, you guys are being sacrilegious, and I said, yeah, you're right, we are. What an absurd thought. How much more sacrilegious than the insidious, down to the very second, taking of a man's life?
Meantime, protests against Harris's scheduled execution continue in the Bay Area. Activists opposed to the death penalty made a symbolic statement on San Francisco's Mount Davidson today, placing a replica of the gas chamber next to the towering concrete cross.
They don't want to see it. It presents a real paradox to them because they voted for it, yet it freaks them out. It bothers them. As we look at the cross, as we set this thing up, it's important that we all stand and take responsibility for something we all are doing.
The replica will be set up outside San Quentin tomorrow as the countdown continues.
You know, it's almost better that more people didn't show up. I like it that way.